Hello, welcome to the next session of Visual Communication Ideas. Today I'll show you how you can explain complex think with a visual simplicity. My name is Peter Zvirinsky and I'm co-founder of Infodiagram, a place where we help people to communicate visually and create cleaner and interactive presentation slides. Today I'll show you some examples of creating simple visual slides explaining more complex concepts, for example, how the AI works. That was actually a question which I was given recently to explain how the artificial intelligence systems or applications, like what's the essence, how they work. And we know that all these applications like ChatGPT, Midjourney, they are able to create some really sophisticated things. However, it's good to understand at least the essence, and I was given this task to explain it to likes, not to some technical people, what's actually essence, how it works. And the heart of AI systems actually is the machine learning algorithms. So machine learning, these are the algorithms which are able to learn based on data they are given. So they are given data which they are trained on. But how is that done? This is quite a complex process, but it could be actually explained as a kind of simple formula, mathematical formula, because that's essentially what it is. The machine learning is trying to create, to calculate some score or some value based on several parameters. So you can imagine it as, for example, you wrote a social media post on LinkedIn, on Facebook, and the system using AI algorithms is able, now it has a task to decide how relevant is this post for your community, how high it should be placed on the ranking of the things which someone else will see on his social media page. And then, so the parameters which the system is probably considering is the time of publishing, so the length of the post, what keywords you used, what is the context, what is the content? So if you put a video over there, if you don't link to external video, so all these things are considered to calculate the score of this post. So this is just kind of formula, and machine learning is calculating this kind of formula. And how to explain it? This you can use visual forms to explain this kind of formula. Let's do it step by step. So firstly, you can explain how the one parameter would look like. So if the score is based on one attribute, then it's a simple function. Okay, if the time is 10 a.m., well, the score will be higher than if you post in midnight, for example. However, in the real world, okay, these parameters, there's much more than, so let's move on. So with two parameters, you could show it visually as metrics or quadrants. So you can show that, okay, your post is depending on, let's say, on time of publishing and length, or time and what kind of keywords you used. So if they are relevant or less relevant. So you have two attributes and you can put this kind of segmentation of the post or explain how this score works. And you can go on with three-dimensional, you can show the three attributes. And okay, going on, it's kind of could be tricky because like it for us is not easy to imagine the four-dimensional space. So I would stop with three dimensions. Even three dimensions sometimes is not that easy to grasp, specifically because we are speaking about the context of presentations where your audience has only seconds to understand the content, the idea which you want to explain. So I would encourage you to use the as simple form as you can explain well, so the audience can grasp fast the idea which you have. So some examples, if you want to show one dimensional dependency, you can use the pyramid or some visual representation of levels, could be just timeline or some layers, two dimensional, all these quadrant diagrams, three dimensional, the cube is good metaphor. So let me show you on example of explaining again how there are two types of AI models. One is discriminative and another one is generative. Generative model is the model which ChatGPT and BART and Midjourney they are using, because they are creating new instances. Unlike the classification models, which their task is actually to decide if, for example, if you are browsing through a web page, so are you a bot or a human user? Is the payment safe or is it a scam? Or is the when the car is taking the picture of the from the camera and see something, is it a pedestrian, something I should stop? Or is it a lamp so I can just pass by? It's like safe object. So these are the questions which discriminative AI is trying to answer, and the generative one is actually, these are examples so they ask to create a picture or write a summary of a book or create new subject for email. And if you want to show this one on example of like of data of this function, we can put it in these two examples. So we can this classification algorithm is trying to calculate the class based on attributes as a function of attributes, and new instance is like creating new data based on again some attributes. So in case we have two, and this is this simple form which people are able to understand quickly, so dimensions we can quite easily imagine. So for example, here the algorithm is actually trying to draw a line, the border between two groups, let's say of the scam transaction and proper transaction. In the case of generating images, generating new instances, you can imagine that again the algorithm is able to learn the groups, but then it's able to not, the goal is not to draw a border but to create a new instance which is from the same group. So if you ask AI to draw a new picture of a cat, it will create something which is similar to other instances of cats which the algorithm has seen and has learned from. So that's the difference between like explaining the difference between two types of AI models using a simple 2D representation of the formula. So as a takeaway, try to make things complex. Try to make complex things more simple with using simple visual algorithms. Some examples you can use visual aids like Venn diagrams, some layers, puzzles. Like all these are very good metaphors, which could be used to explain some simple concepts to explain some more, like at the end, some more complex ideas. So, to learn more, get some more examples and tips, I encourage you to visit our webpage infodiagram.com/freesample. You'll find there some free graphics to start with, and also you can sign up there for email tutorial which is sent to you. Like there are a series of three emails which are where I explain how to use other visual aids in order to make nice visual presentations. So thank you for listening, and see you at the next session.